Hi, I'm Paul Wells from Agile J. The SWT, what is it and what problem does it solve? In a previous video, we saw how Java gives us something called a virtual machine, which shields our application from the particulars of the operating system that we want it to run on. Now, one of the particulars might well be the user interface, that is the windowing system. And a windowing system is made up of things like, well, windows obviously, but buttons, lists, images, printing, fonts, icons, graphics, mouse events, key events, all sorts of things like that. So let's concentrate on how the VM gives us access to all of those different windowing parts. Inside the VM is a component called the AWT, Abstract Windowing Toolkit, and that's what we're basically looking at to start with. So this part of the VM provides all of those things, buttons, icons, support for printing, everything I just mentioned, and they appear in part of the API here, and our application talks through this API and requests things like buttons, lists, fonts, text to be placed here, and to be notified when mouse events happen, keyboard events happen, things like that. And this was Java's first attempt at supporting user interfaces and windowing applications across many platforms. However, it quickly became apparent that there were a number of problems with using this arrangement. Remember, we've got, in reality, different VMs talking down to different operating systems. And the operating systems, yes, they will have things like buttons and lists and fonts. And so this thing was designed to be something which supports the least common denominator across all the operating systems. I've written applications that use just the AWT. It's fine for simple applications where you ask the user to fill in a form, put in some details, and press a button to submit those details. The problem comes when you want to support richer applications which do much more things like trees and lists and heavier use of graphics and that sort of thing. So the AWT had the problem that it couldn't set its API too wide, because then it wouldn't be able to run on all of the different operating systems that might come along, but it couldn't set it too narrow, because you could only write noddy little programs for it. So then what they decided to do in order to get around this problem was to extend the AWT and produce something much wider called Swing. And what Swing would do is use the window framing, the windowing part of the AWT. The AWT was still there, but what they said was, look, we will handle the drawing of these richer windowing GUIs that programmers want and that users want to see. We will provide all of these in an API up here. And what we will do is, yes, we'll use the AWT for the window, but everything else we will do a simulation inside here. We'll do an emulation, and then all we will ask of the operating system is, please give us a window, please give us a blank canvas. We will draw things like buttons and lists and fonts and everything, so the logic of the richer part of the windowing will take place inside here. Then it isn't down to the operating system anymore to provide a rich set of windowing widgets, because this thing will step in and provide those widgets where they're needed. It will provide all of them, and it will provide them on every platform. What was also touted as a benefit of this was that you could have something called the look and feel. You could make that pluggable, so you could switch it and you could run any look and feel on any platform. However, Swing also had problems. Not least of the problems was the fact that Microsoft were not very happy with a Windows emulator being built. Also, there was the problem that whenever one of these operating systems updated the look and feel, the native look and feel, so for example when there was a switch from Windows 2000 to XP or to Vista or whatever, it was then the job of these guys to write a new look and feel to keep step with the platform. There was also the problem that because this is an emulation and the operating system is highly optimized, it didn't quite run as quick because this was drawing buttons and drawing everything and responding to everything and not making use of the optimizations that were in the operating system. So what happened was, along came Eclipse with something called the SWT. And the difference with the SWT is, it is a wide API, so you do get a rich set of widgets that you can use to make good-looking, useful applications. But instead of using an emulation, what actually happened was that the SWT sat with a native component. So there was a native component written for each operating system. I mean, the upshot of it is that the SWT works, so whenever you ask for a button, the SWT will go to the native operating system and the native operating system will provide that button or whatever component it is that you ask for. Where the operating system doesn't provide a widget that you want, then it steps in and provides some extra logic to patch up, if you like, or to make sure that the platform that you're running on still fulfills the contract of this wider API. Now, the advantage of that is that, yes, you end up with something that's taking advantage of the optimizations of the operating system, so it does run a little bit faster. But equally well, when the operating system itself gets updated, well then the update to your application happens automatically. But above all, the main advantage of the SWT is that when you write your application and deploy it, it doesn't look like something alien. It looks like something that was written for the operating system that it's running on.